for such a long time, and there's a big hand of yours behind Madhuri Dixit's success. So I just want you to describe Madhuri as a dancer.
इतना बोल सकती हूँ कि वो हीरा है जिसको मैंने तराशा. शी एज अ डांसर इट वॉज इन हर. सी बेसिकली शी हैड इट इन हर बिकॉज शी वॉज लर्निंग कथक फ्रॉम यंग एज. आई कांट से शी वॉजंट अ डांसर बट ऑल द गुड पॉइंट्स हैड टू बी ब्रॉट आउट एंड दैट्स वॉट आई डिड. इट इज़ लाइक पॉलिशिंग अ डायमंड. So I just polished a diamond.
Ma'am, your first experience with Madhuri, you know, when you met Madhuri first. So I just want you to describe that experience.
Actually, I was doing a picture called Avara Bap. So Madhuri was playing girlfriend of Rajan Sippy. That time Subhash ji had asked me for a girl who would dance in outdoor shooting for a dream sequence where this girl and boy are dancing. Sridevi comes and stands, Jackie comes, and they both see this girl dancing and they go into a dream. He wanted just a girl from group dancer. So the girl he named was not available. Then I told him, I said, Subhashji, I have a girl who's working with me in Avara Bap. She's a very good dancer, means what I have seen, though she was only doing a ballroom piece. So Subhash ji said, bring anybody, because she has only to do a small mukhra, you call it, the beginning of the music and song, and then they go into a dream, then she's not concerned. So we went to Kashmir, she and her mother and myself. I had composed the dance. It was supposed to be a shooting, fake shooting. So there were two round trolleys. In the center, Madhuri and his nephew called Raju was dancing. And me and Subhashji, like dance director and producer. And the camera would roll and come to us. We'll say cut and start. So when he saw her dancing, he asked me, he says, where did you bring this girl from? So I said, I told you she was working with me in Avara Bap. So he said, tell her mother that just, I mean, hide her for 6 months, then I'll give her a break. That's how we met. And then he gave her a break in Uttar Dakshin with Jackie. So there my, you know, mostly all the dances was done by me for Subhash ji. For every picture, I did the full dances, but that time she was little more like Kathak dancer rather than filmy dancer. We kept on working together. She would feel nervous, she would cry, everything would happen. But I would only tell her that now this is the time you have to pick up courage, because Subhashji has got a habit of shouting, so she couldn't bear that. But anyhow, she finished that picture. And then we again met for Tezab. Before that also I did another picture which I don't remember the names. I'm very weak at names. But in Tezab we met again for Ek Do Teen. And that's the time when she said, Masterji, I'll rehearse for a month and then do the song. I said, okay. But within 10 days she was very good. So I told her, I said, MD, you don't come. I'll take up the group. She said, no, Masterji, you take up the group, but I'll keep on rehearsing. For 17 days, that girl came to this hall only, Satyam, from 10 to 10. She would keep on dancing. And the result, you can see, she never looked back. And after that, it was like me and she were like mother and daughter. I used to look upon her like a daughter only. Slowly, slowly, you know how it is. You keep on dancing, you start flourishing. So that's what happened with MD. She was a beautiful dancer, and I know she has left a gap. Nobody can fill up that gap.
Ma'am, I just wanted to know that the first, very first moment when you saw Madhuri, What did you think about Madhuri when you met, and after she performed, what was your opinion about Madhuri?
See, the first time we met is in Avarabhav, where she was doing a ballroom. So she was a simple girl. I didn't even know her background, nothing. So I used to teach her like a master and go away. I hadn't that interest in her. Because Rajesh Khanna was supposed to be singing, Meenakshi was there. But when we came face to face in Uttar Dakshin, that was the time I realized that if I mold this girl to my style, I might get too much out of her. So that hope was there from my side. Because you really crave for a person who can understand your dance. She used to watch me and perform to the T. I mean, if I have said, just lift one eyebrow, she will not do the second one. If I say, just give half a look, she will not do full. She followed me to the T, the moods, everything in the dance. I think she's a dream for anybody to work with. Between her and me, we have been very close. Very close in a sense, don't take it like I know her life inside out. No. As far as our work was concerned, we were very near. Like, when I look into her eyes, I know she has liked the moment or she doesn't like the moment. So she didn't have to say, Masterji, change this. I would automatically change it. And that smile would come when she understood that I understood. And many times we have done very sensuous dances, but she knew she could trust me like a mother, that I will not portray it very badly or vulgarly. I would look at her and think how beautiful she is. A man should look at her like a beautiful lady, not as a cheap girl or vulgar. So my movements were never vulgar for her. Even if I'm giving bust movements, her face was so innocent that bust wouldn't hit you like that. It would become very sensuous. You know, sometimes girls shake their bust purposely, you feel that. But the way she would keep that innocent look and do the movement, it was not purposely done. If she is talking about dhak dhak, she is talking about the heartbeat, and it wasn't a dhak dhak like that. It was very dhak dhak, very soft, but you felt it. That was the quality in her. And she became so used to my dances, so used to my dances. One thing about her and me, one understanding, that she would never ever suggest my name until that place is empty. Until the producer really inquires about me, that do you want Saroj, then only give my name, otherwise don't. Whoever's dancing with you, whoever master is there, just do it. So she, in Sajan, she did it with Chinni Prakash, like in Dil To Pagal Hai, she danced with Shamak and also with Farah Khan. She was never, she was not like Sridevi. Sridevi would change dates. Saroj not available, change the dates. I will not do the dance without her. Between her and me, this was not the understanding. So even she worked out, I didn't feel bad. Neither I went to her sets to inquire why she didn't call me. That relationship was very precious. See, when you have 5 kids, you cannot say which are your favorites. With her, I have performed the best. I can say that. Every song of hers would turn out to be very different.
Still, if you can say that, yeah, this song you have enjoyed a lot to choreograph, and it really turned out to be what you were expecting.
That's Dhak Dhak, of course. She had very less of time to do that, but she did it very well. Within 3 nights, we finished that because the picture was releasing. Ek Do Teen, she performed beautifully. If you go to see, I think the best of hers is in even Chane Ke Khet Mein. Her expressions, I don't think anybody can change expression so many times on the face. Yes, I can say that. She still has too much in her.
What do you think, what extra Madhuri gave to her dance?
She had that oomph, you can call, or the X factor, you can call, which came through the heart to the eyes, which nobody does. Nobody.
What do you like the best in Madhuri? When she dances, what do you like?
Her perfection. Her enjoyment of dance. She was like, she would make you stand up on your toes, that you too want to dance. She had that quality.
Saroji, tell me that Madhuri has a very infectious smile. Whenever she smiles, people fall for her. Did you ever use that smile knowingly?
She had that smile which was very rare, a very innocent smile which anybody would fall in love with. And she knew how to use it. You know, suddenly the smile breaking out, it was like a sunshine. It was, you really felt the days come alive. Mostly in rehearsal, she wouldn't do the expression so much. But when the take used to happen, something magic used to happen. Whereas even the cameramans used to forget cutting the shot. It was that, oh, I'm going to miss her very much.
I really believe you that in that point, ma'am. And about Hrithik, quickly about Hrithik, what do you think, how he dances?
He's a god. That's all I can say, one word. He's a god in dance. But still, Govinda takes over because of his expression, because of his enjoyment, like how Madhuri enjoys the dance. Like that, he is too perfect to be true. You know, people when they watch, they simply feel, we cannot do all this. But with Govinda, you want to get up and dance with him. It's as simple as that.
Very correctly said, and as you said that Govinda is very spontaneous, very believable.
Very, very, very.
So what's the quality in Hrithik that makes him apart?
Because he's too perfect. Every movement of his body can be seen. A dancer has to show his body how it moves. And all his moves are very smooth. They are never strenuous. You never feel he's trying to do it or he's trying to be a dancer. It's inborn. It's in him.
So tell me about your first meeting when you met her first.
Oh, we have worked when I was very small and she had just entered the industry. Then I worked with her when I was assistant. Then I worked with her as a choreographer also. There was a picture called Bombay Talkie. And it was she was dancing on a typewriter. So the original choreographer couldn't understand what to do. So she sent for me urgently. And when she made her comeback also, Khamoshi, she told Sanjay Bansali, I want Saroj Khan to direct me. And it was a pleasure to do that.
And what do you think is so special about her? I mean, Helen has been talked about so much.
She is a very dignified lady. Even if she wears the smallest costume, you'll never feel it's vulgar. What not costumes she has worn. Even today's day and age, nobody can wear those sort of costumes. But you still feel that she belongs to that costume. She's not wearing it just because she has to dance. The style, the hairstyle, everything matches the costumes. She had the knack of putting everything together by herself. Even the makeup. Even what lenses she's going to use or what eyelashes she's going to use. She used to design it. All the jewelry was designed by her. All the costumes were designed by her. If anybody says that I have designed Helen's costume, just bring that person to me. She's a princess of dance. There are no words, and nobody can fill that gap.
I know, but contemporaries, who do you think comes closest to Helen? I know it's hard to come close to Helen.
No, I can't say about that. I can't even compare anybody. I can't even think about it.
So tell me, she was called the golden girl for ages. She's still called the golden girl.
Yes.
Do you think how much justified is that tag and why is
it? It is justified. You can see the songs that she has done. I mean, see the moments. I don't think anybody can do Aa Jaane Ja. The movements that she has done in that, and the style she keeps with those long legs. Just show me one lady who has that long legs. No. It's even in my dream, I can't think another Helen will come.
Now I'm going to ask you the toughest question. The toughest question is to choose between one Helen song. Which is your favorite Helen song and why?
I love Aa Jaane Ja. Because it's such a differently choreographed and well picturized, and she has danced very, very well.
So out of the two, Madhuri or Helen?
No. They both have different sides. You can't compare them. They both have left a gap in this industry.
Ma'am, I think that these stars, all of them, were extremely lucky to work with you, and I guess you're the luckiest choreographer to work with Helen and Madhuri both. Thank you so much.